It's your girl Mariah Lynn, and you are now rocking with Raw Hollywood.
What's going on, Team Hollywood? This is Virgil in New York City with Mariah Lynn. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm good, good, good. So let's briefly talk about Love and Hip Hop. What made you join Love and Hip Hop?
Honestly, what made me join was knowing and acknowledging that there was a platform, a major platform, to utilize to showcase my talents. Right. So.
And what has it learned? Because, you know, it's drama, it's so much.
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot. It's a gift and a curse. I would say it's more of what you do with it, you know, how you utilize the platform, how you, you know, put your image, your brand, your name out there, and the perception that you leave the people with. And one thing I've learned is watching myself, seeing how to grow, where I need to grow. You know, development and evolution, and that's where I'm at in my career right now.
Right, great, great, great. So do you think you'll return for another season?
I don't think at this point they'll be the same without me. So with that being said, you know, you guys will have to stay tuned, but I'm a commodity and a brand in my own right without Love and Hip Hop. So new projects, new music, new major A-list collaborations coming soon, and a new Mariah Lynn.
Right. Speaking of projects, The Blonde Bomber.
That was my first project I've ever put out.
Yes.
My EP.
How was it recording that?
Emotional. You know, sleepless nights in the studio. Me actually applying what was going on in my real life into the music. It was very emotional. There were times I would cry in the booth. There were times I would fall asleep writing a verse, wake up 20 minutes later, say, let's move on to the next thing, you know. But overall, it was a huge learning experience for me. And it also taught me what I'm lacking, especially when it comes to, like, you know, putting out a project independently as an independent artist. You know, you have to make sure that you have all of the marketing and all of, you know, the major machine behind you. So now I know what I need to go for, and I'm coming for it, believe me.
Now it's Pride Month.
Yes, happy Pride.
And those of, you know, many people may not know, today is the 2-year anniversary of what happened in
Pulse. Yes.
And around that time, you came out with an amazing song that I love called Rainbow.
Yes.
What pushed you to come out with that song?
The motivation behind Rainbow, and I don't want to get too emotional because I was actually performing at Pulse 2 weeks before the massacre. So I felt so touched by this tragedy that I felt like it could have been me. Could have been you. It could have been anybody in that club at that time. And, you know, I'm a huge advocate for the LGBTQ community. Like, you know, they're my family, and for many other communities, but a lot of people know that, you know, I kind of favor, you know, the LGBT community.
Because we're a lot of fun.
Yes, of course. Yes, you're a lot of fun. And, you know, I love that y'all love me, flaws and all. So that's why, you know, I was really motivated and determined to show the gay community and everybody that, you know, you do have my continuous support forever, you know?
Definitely on behalf of myself and even the LGBTQ community, we're very thankful to have someone like you who love and respect us.
Thank you so much.
So you're a artist, a very talented artist.
Thank you.
What's your opinion on rap beefs when it comes, especially the females?
With beats or songs?
What songs, when people, you know, the cattiness of it. Kind of thing.
I don't really get involved with the cattiness anymore. Right. You know, once upon a time, not long ago, I did. But I am a new person, like I said, again, welcoming everybody to the evolution of Mariah Lynn, which is a new attitude, a new, you know, outlook just on everything. And, you know, what I'm going through in my life, you know, I give to the people. I give to them on Love and Hip Hop, but they don't get to see, you know, when I wake up every morning to my baby sister who I have custody of.
Right.
You know, how I take care of my 20-year-old sister, my 2-year-old nephew, they reside with me. How I give back to all different types of communities, you know, Boys and Girls Club, children whose parents are incarcerated, who are being raised by their grandparents, which I was partially raised by my aunt. I was bounced around as a child. So, you know, I have always lacked stability and consistency. And what I've learned from Love and Hip Hop, what I've learned from being in the industry, is just being able to conquer and control those emotions, you know?
Right.
You can't.
Well, look, I'm definitely rooting for you. I'm a fan.
Yeah,
and
I'm a fan of this. Look, every
moment
together.
I was coming here with you, so I had to make sure I look as fly as possible. But thank you. I really appreciate
thank
Mariah.
You so much.
You're
I
welcome.
Appreciate you.